In this video, we are going to study one of the important topic of statistics, that is measure of center, or we also used to call center tendency. So before that, I would like to request you, please subscribe my channel. It motivates me also, and you also will be getting notified when I add the new videos. Thank you. So what is the measure of tendency? Before going for definition and all the calculations, let me ask you one question. So suppose in one school, many students has given one exam. So first thing, what do you ask? First questions, or the person used to ask, what is the average marks obtained by the student? Or if any company has been running for last 10 years, you used to ask the questions, what is the average income of this company? So always, person want to know one short answer for the detailed complete data. That is called the center of tendency. So if you have the huge data and you want to represent the huge data in one sentence, one number, that is called the measure of center or center tendency. And we have the many mechanism to find out the center tendency. Mean, median and mode. I will be explaining in which case we should use the mean and the median and the mode, and what are the different kind of calculation behind this all three terminology. So first let us go for the definition. So the important objective of any analytics, statistical analytics, to determine a single value for the entire data set. So if if you can get the single value for the entire data set, that is called the measure of center or the center tendency, or that number represent the whole data, means representation of the whole set of data, that is called the center of center tendency. So as I asked, there are the three way to measure the center tendency, that is the mean, median and mode. Depend upon the data, our calculation would be the different. If the data is individual data, so this is the individual data 3, 4, 3, 1, 2, 9, then formula is different. If you have the group data, group data means from 30 to 40, from 40 to 60, this kind of data is called the group data. We will discuss one by one. So in this video, we are going to study the individual data. So let us start. What is mean? Mean represented by x bar, and this is also called the arithmetic average, and this is most commonly used, easy to calculate, and always very useful but depend upon the data. So we will go the 3 points later. First we understand how it is going to calculate. So suppose if you have the data x1, x2, x3 and xn, so what you have to do, so easy, you add all those numbers and divide it by how many numbers are there. So in this case, we have the n number, so we add all the numbers and divide it by n. So if you want in short, so summation of for all the x from 1 to n and divided by n, this is the formula for the mean. Take one example. So suppose we had been given the this data, this 1, 2, 3, 4, 3, 4, 3, 1, 2, 3, 9, 5, this one. So what is the mean of this given data? So x bar is what we have to do, add all the number and divide it by how many numbers given. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. We have 12. So add all the number, it becomes the 55 by 12, and then this is the mean. So x bar is equal to 4.583. Okay. So we understand this point. Now the third point, very important. It is saying we should use the mean when data is very fair and uniform. So why it means very fair? So suppose this data is very fair, means if you see all the data almost more or less the same, variance is not much high. So in that case we use the mean. But if data has some outlier, outlier is called the most affected data or some big number of data. So suppose in this case by mistake we got one outlier, instead of the 8 it is 800. It is by mistake, by the data entry operator mistake or printing mistake. Anyhow, if we get this kind of outsider data in my data set, that is also called the outlier. Now you calculate the mean, then I will come to know. So when you calculate the mean, this become the 800 and this become the, I have already calculated, 847, then the 12, then this is your mean. Now see the difference. Earlier mean was the 4.58 and this number very much more or less equal to all the numbers. But if you see, due to one number, our mean has been changed from 4 to 70 and none of the number is near to this the mean. So that's why in this case we can't use the mean. So that's why if our data set has the outlier, mean is we give the very bad answer. Okay. Second thing, sum of the each score distance from variance always be zero. What do you mean? For easy example, suppose I have the this data 5, 6, 3, 2, 4. Calculate the mean. What is the mean of this? So by 5, so it will be 20/5, 4. So in this case, mean is 4. Now check the distance of the each data. So 5 minus 4, how much? 1. 6 minus 4, 2. 3 minus 4, -1. 2 minus 4, -2. 4 plus 4, 0. If you add all this number, it you will get always get the 0. So this is the property of the mean. Now, so with the same data set, how to calculate the median? To calculate the median, first you arrange the data in sorted form, either lower to higher or higher to lower, then select the middle one. So in this case, if you arrange the data in sorted form, you will get this one. And say how many datas are there? So we know the 12 data. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. So if you see, these two comes in the middle. 5 this side, 5 this side. This is the middle. So now you have to take the average of the middle. So median of this data set is the 4. But think, suppose we have one more data, not the even number. Suppose if you have the odd number, I have 10 also. Then this 4 is the median, right? So in this case, the 4 would be median. So because the 6 is this side and 6 is this side. So if this is the even number, you take the both number and divide it by 2. If this is the odd number, then take the middle data. But don't forget, first you have to make in sorted order. So when I used to median, as I said in the mean case, if data has outlier, then mean would be more affected. We have calculated that time, but in this case there is no impact of the outlier. So say instead of the 10, I have the, suppose I have the 1000 or 10,000 also, even though in this case also median is the same, so median will be the same, no impact. This also called the median score. As I say, this is the median score. And this median is also called the fifth percentile, is in between that. This is the fifth percentile we used to call. Now third one is the mod. When is the mod? If data is the nominal data or the largest frequency. So suppose if you want to check this category, how many this category is there, how many that category is there, in that case we can check the mod. So if the same data set, if I want to calculate the mod, how we calculate? So check the number who comes more time. So 3 has comes 3 times, 4 has comes two times. So most of time 3 came, so that's why more would be the 3. But that is not applicable in the all the case. It might be not the unique. So suppose 4 also come the 3 times, suppose, then answer would be the 3 and 4 both. So according to data set, mod could not be unique also. If you get the unique answer, this is called the unimod. So the first example, it was a unimod. In the second example, this is the bimod. So we can have the trimod, polymod in the case of the mod. So that we discuss about when the data is the individual data. Okay. Now if you go discuss about when the data is the group data. Thank you.